had an uncle who passed away. So when we found out, the only thing I knew is that they said, you know, your Uncle Mitch is in the hospital, caught COVID. And I was like, you know, how could that happen? You know, he doesn't go anywhere. But, you know, when it first happened, when people are not wearing masks and, you know, they go out to the community or their jobs or hanging around certain people, you don't know where those people have been. You don't know who they're hanging out with, talking to on the regular, dealing with at their job. You know, so you're bringing that stuff home or you're just, you know, around it. They said, you know, he has COVID, you know, he's developing pneumonia, can't breathe, he's not breathing on his own. So I was getting mixed signals, like he was doing better, he's not, he's still not breathing. And then sometime later, I get a text from my dad early in the morning, your Uncle Mitch died. And I just kind of roll over and I'm just trying to process everything, and it just didn't seem real. And a lot of things don't seem real when they happen to you, or when they happen, unless it happens directly to you and directly affects you.
What inspired me to actually get the vaccination was hearing those two stories of the close ones, my family, getting it, and what that meant for them and the things they had to go through. And, you know, when you hear those kind of stories, it's like, you can hear it, but until you actually feel it, you know, you're kind of like, well, this might be something that I don't want to ever, you know, go through.
Before I was even conscious of it, I've been getting vaccines, you know, inserted in my body ever since, and they've worked. I haven't gotten any life-threatening diseases. I've been safe, I've been secure, my immune system's been doing its job. So I don't see any reason to fear or suspect any suspicion when there are multiple World Health Organizations telling me that this vaccine is perfectly fine for me.
Some of my inspiration to take it, to be able to be part of, first of all, to help decrease the contraction of COVID, but on top of that, to help reopen the economy so we could go back to a sense of normalcy.
This is something that we don't know about. It's very serious. We saw a lot of people dying in Italy, Brazil, India, all over the country, right here in our neck of the woods. And it's something that we don't know about. It's foreign to us. And so in order for me to protect myself, my loved ones, and hopefully end this pandemic, then I thought that getting the vaccine would be the right thing to do.
My father, he works for NIH, and so he's kind of like was on the front line, and he knows the people that are on the front line with the research. And, you know, he just broke it down to me. He was like, vaccines, you know, they help. It's not a cure, but it helps you fend off and less chances. So it was kind of a straightforward, okay, I'd rather have a fighting chance than no chance.
Honestly, I never really had any hesitations on it, only because I've been deployed twice to Afghanistan. And before going over there, you have to have all types of vaccine shots. I had like 12 each time I went. And I never did the research on those. So I didn't know what was in those, but I know like I didn't get sick or anything from those. So I was like, hey, you know, at least now I have the opportunity to do research on the vaccine before taking it. So that's what I did. I just did my due diligence and did my own research.
Just take the vaccine.
Get 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 the vaccine.
Just get the vaccine.